Hello and welcome. You have tuned into Headlines Now with me, Linda Hercules. Before we move into all the stories in detail, let's take a quick look at the top headlines. The Apex Court wraps the centre for not auctioning the entire 2G spectrum, says centre is playing with its order. The deadline for an implementation of television digitization program in Chennai has been extended. Efforts to salvage grounded ship Pratibha Kaveri continues without success. Arvind Kejriwal accuses Mukesh and Anand Ambani along with two others of allegedly siphoning crores of black money to Swiss accounts. The Ambani brothers reject Kejriwal's allegations, deny having any illegitimate accounts anywhere. The Azure PLC agrees to buy a 53.4% stake in Vijay Mallya's United Spirits Limited for more than $2 billion. The BJP slams Ram Jethmalani's controversial comment on Lord Rama, accusing him of being a bad husband. News in detail. The Supreme Court today pulled up the centre for not following its February 2nd order of auctioning the entire 2G spectrum, made available after cancellation of 122 licences and also state proceedings of petitions relating to the scam in the Delhi High Court. Unhappy that the centre was only auctioning in the 800 MHz and 1800 MHz bands, the court said that prima facie the centre was found not carrying out the order but playing with it. A bench of Justice G.S. Singhvi and Justice K.S. Radhakrishnan stated that all proceedings pending in the Delhi High Court shall remain stayed. It also issued notices and sought the replies of various parties within 6 weeks. Among the petitions are those from former Telecom Minister and Prime Accused A. Raja, DMK MP Kanimuri and others seeking quashing of 2G cases against them. The CBI had cited a Supreme Court order of April 2011 that directed that no other court shall entertain any application relating to the 2G case. The court was informed that 20 petitions were pending before the High Court. On to news from the city, the deadline for implementation of television digitization program at Chennai has been extended for the third time today. The program was originally planned on the 31st of October but got extended since the Madras High Court was hearing a petition filed by the cable operators and Tamil Nadu government-run MSO for extension of the deadline. During the hearing, one of the multi-system operators called Jack Communication asked for time to file an affidavit and the court posted the matter for the 19th of November. The court also said that the issue involved public interest and shall be considered in a division bench in the next sitting. It therefore means analog cable connection in Chennai will not get cut till the date of hearing. Efforts to salvage the ship grounded by the 31st October cyclone Nilam on Chennai beach, Pratibha Kaveri, continued for the second day today, but without success. A team from Singapore-based company Smith Salvage unsuccessfully tried to pull the ship out during high tide around 4:30 a.m. It will try to tow the ship once again when the high tide returns in evening.
The scene at Marina is the same for over 24 hours now. You can very clearly see the public who are gathered here at the Marina to catch a glimpse of the standard ship Pratibha Kaveri. If my camera person could just pan to his right, you can very clearly see the vessel Malavia, which is trying to move the ship Pratibha Kaveri with the help of a thick rope. There is another vessel named Ratna, which is stationed at the Chennai port. Ratna belongs to the government of India. Basically, Ratna will be guarding the east coast of India. Say, for example, if there is any other cyclone, the ship Ratna will be used to move the standard ship from the coast to the mid-sea. In short, it will be very helpful in case of any cyclone that similar fate can be avoided to any other ship. Similarly, the Chennai police say that they have registered a case and kick-started a probe, but they have asked some details from the Port Trust authorities, but the Port Trust authorities have very clearly said that they'll be in a position to give the details only on the 12th of this month. So Chennai police say, meanwhile, their investigation is also on in another different angle, but only when they get details from the port authorities, they will be in a clear position to move forward in this case.
Moving on, as part of efforts to expedite the projects jointly being implemented by the centre and the state, Prime Minister's advisor TKA Nair met Chief Minister Jayalalitha. During the meeting at the Secretariat, they discussed the implementation of various programmes jointly taken up by the centre and the state government. They were joined by Chief Secretary Debendranath Sarangi, Pallavi Jain, Director in the Prime Minister's office and other senior state government officials. With his reported comments about DMK on the Kodankulam nuclear power plant issue rubbing the wrong way, Union Minister V. Narayanaswamy sought to assuage the irked feelings of party chief M. Karunanidhi, saying that ties between Congress and its ally were stronger. disputing Narayanaswamy's reported comments to a Tamil weekly that AIADMK consistently supported the project, but the DMK had changed. Karunanidhi stated that his party was not against the project and that it always supported industrial growth in a scientific manner. Narayanaswamy said that his comments had been published in such a manner so as to create a rift between the Congress and the DMK.
I came to know of the interview that has been published only after Dr. Kalanjar, DMK leader, gave a statement saying that they have been supporting the Kudankulam nuclear power plant throughout. In fact, when the correspondent asked me about the who are all supporting the Kudankulam nuclear power plant, I made it very clear that the DMK has been supporting the Kudankulam nuclear power plant for a long time. The project was constructed at the time Dr. Kalanjar was the Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, and their support is continued to be there. Now the present Chief Minister, Tamil Nadu, is also supporting the project. That's what I said. But it was twisted in the magazine saying that we don't want DMK support and we want only ADMK support. This is a mischief which has been published in the magazine. The Congress and DMK, we are having very good relations inside the parliament and outside parliament. This kind of mischievous statement has been printed to create a wedge between Congress and DMK.
Over to news from Dharmapuri. Angered by a man committing suicide over his daughter marrying a Dalit boy, a mob torched 285 huts in three Dalit colonies. However, no casualties have been reported as all the people had fled to neighbouring areas. The villagers had got wind of the impending attack beforehand and fled. Sanjay Kumar, DIG of Salem, said that 90 persons have been arrested in connection with the violence so far and that armed police personnel had been posted in the villages. He added that the couple were in a safe area under police protection.
ஹைக்கிங் கொட்டாய் சந்தையில் எங்கள் ஊரெல்லாம் வந்து எரிச்சு பெட்ரோல் ஊற்றி கொளுத்தி ஜனங்கள்லாம் வண்டியில் வந்து எல்லாம் அடித்து நொறுக்கி துணி கூட இல்லை, புளிங்க படிக்கிறதுக்கு பை கூட இல்லை, புக்கு இல்லை, நோட்டு இல்லை, எதுவுமே இல்லை, போட்டுக்க வழி இல்லை, கார்டு இல்லை, ரேஷன் கார்டு இல்லை, எதுவுமே இல்லை. அதை முடிக்க எங்களை அடித்து நொறுக்கிட்டாங்க. தோடு நெகை எல்லாமே எங்களுக்கு போயிடுச்சு சார். என்னமே இல்லை. நாங்கள் என்ன பண்ணி நாங்கள் வாழ்கிறது? எங்கள் பிள்ளைங்களை வச்சு சோத்து கூட வழி இல்லை.
பெட்ரோல் வெடிகுண்டு கொண்டு வந்து வீசி ஆம்பளையெல்லாம் அடித்து காயப்படுத்தி பெட்ரோல் சேர்த்துட்டு எங்கள் வீட்டில் வண்டி பசங்க டீசி ரேஷனு கேஸு டிவி அத்தனை அனைத்து பொருள் சோஃபா கட்டு அரிசி பணம் பவுனு எல்லாத்தையும் சேதம் பண்ணி எல்லாம் அள்ளிட்டு ஒரு 600 பேர் வந்து மூணுல வண்டியில் இறங்கி எல்லாத்தையும் திறந்து பொம்பளை புள்ள குட்டியெல்லாம் அடிச்சு எங்களை புண்படுத்தி தொந்தரவு பண்ணிட்டாங்க சார்.
National News. Activist turned politician Arvind Kejriwal today accused industrialist Mukesh and Anil Ambani, Jet Airways owner Naresh Goyal and Congress MP Anu Tandon of allegedly siphoning crores of black money to Swiss accounts. Mr. Kejriwal had in July last year said that the government was given a list of 700 Indians with HSBC accounts in Geneva along with details of their bank balance as of 2006. The total of those accounts, Mr. Kejriwal said, added up to 6,000 crore rupees. In July, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee had told the parliament that no MPs were on the list. However, Mr. Kejriwal said that the information furnished to him showed a Congress MP named Anu Tandon, who he described as close to Congress leader Rahul Gandhi, with a bank balance of 125 crore rupees. He went on to allege that Mukesh Ambani met with the then finance minister Pranab Mukherjee and persuaded him not to raid Reliance Industries and that he was willing to pay up taxes to buy peace.
एचएसबीसी वाले इस देश के अंदर मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग कर रहे हैं, एचएसबीसी वाले हवाला कर रहे हैं। अगर मुकेश अंबानी और अनिल अंबानी की भी ऐसे स्टेटमेंट ली जाती, अगर उनके ऊपर रेड होती तो उनको भी बताना पड़ता कि ये 100 करोड़ रुपया भारत से जेनेवा पहुंचा कैसे, कहां से पहुंचा, बैंकिंग चैनल्स के थ्रू पहुंचा या 100 करोड़ का कैश दिया था यहां पे, वहां जमा हो गया था, और ये ऑपरेट कैसे करते हैं बैंक अकाउंट, तो पता चलता कि अंबानी ब्रदर्स ने भी क्या हवाला कर रखा है, क्या वो भी हवाला में शामिल है। ये तो बहुत सीरियस बात है। अगर नरेश गोयल जी के यहां रेड होती और उनका स्टेटमेंट लिया जाता तो पता चलता कि उन्होंने भी हवाला कर रखा है क्या, वो कैसे ऑपरेट करते हैं अपने बैंक अकाउंट को, अगर डाबर वालों के यहाँ भी रेड होती, अगर बिड़ला वालों के यहाँ भी रेड होती, तो पता चलता ये पैसा कैसे विड्रॉ हो रहा है, कैसे यहाँ पे कैश दिया गया, कैसे हो रहा है। हम प्रणब मुखर्जी साहब से पूछना चाहते हैं कि इनकम टैक्स एक्ट की कौन सी धारा के अंदर आपके पास ये पावर है कि आप क्रिमिनल प्रोसीडिंग्स को रोक सकते हैं। मैं भी इनकम टैक्स के अंदर अधिकारी था। कौन सी धारा फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर को यह पावर देती है कि जो टैक्स की चोरी करे इस देश के अंदर उसको क्रिमिनल प्रोसिक्यूशन से छुट्टी दे दी जाए। अमेरिका कह रहा है कि एचएसबीसी के ऑपरेशंस भारत में आतंकवाद के लिए खतरा पैदा कर सकता है, लेकिन हमारी सरकार कहती है नहीं नहीं एचएसबीसी ठीक है। तो या तो भारत सरकार बिल्कुल निकम्मी है, उसको समझ ही नहीं आ रहा क्या हो रहा है। लेकिन मैं ऐसा नहीं मानता भारत सरकार निकम्मी है, भारत सरकार बिकी हुई है। और भारत सरकार आज मुझे कहने में कोई शक नहीं है, मनमोहन सिंह सरकार इस देश के लिए सबसे बड़ा खतरा पैदा हो गई है। इस देश की इकोनॉमिक सॉवरेंटी के लिए मनमोहन सिंह सरकार इस देश की हमारी प्रभुता के लिए सबसे बड़ा खतरा पैदा हो गई है।
The allegations that I am hearing from you or I am watching on the TV and the ones that IAC and Arvind Kejriwal have made are completely baseless, they are malicious, and I completely deny any such rubbish that has ever. I don't know anything about it. I don't know what he's talking about, and I don't want to discuss something that I feel that it's just a pure waste of time, energy, and I have better things in this world to do. I have my constituency, I have my people. I wish these people would work for the poor as much as it's required.
Iska hum to dhikkar karte hain, nishchit karte hain कि छोटे लोगों को पकड़ते बड़े छोड़ देते, ये तो ठीक नहीं है। साहब की मैं तो बोलता है कि इनकी ऐसे लोगों की जांच न्यायालयीन जांच होनी चाहिए, सीबीआई वगैरह नहीं।
The Ambani brothers rejected Kejriwal's allegations and denied that they had any accounts there. Mukesh Ambani, headed Reliance Industries Limited, said that neither the company nor Mukesh Ambani have or had any illegitimate accounts anywhere in the world. In a separate statement, the Anil Ambani-headed Reliance Group categorically denied all allegations made by Mr. Kejriwal against him and said that Anil Ambani had no bank accounts with HSBC in Geneva. With Arvind Kejriwal targeting the issue of black money and claiming to have a list of 700 Indians who have accounts in HSBC's branch in Geneva, BJP leader Rajiv Pratap Rudi asked Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh to come forth with a befitting reply to all the charges levelled by the India Against Corruption chief. The spokesperson of the BJP said that the charges that have been levelled by Kejriwal were a matter of deep concern.
The Prime Minister of this country did say once that after he took charge of UPA2, that he's going to get back the black money. It's almost 3.5 years, not a single rupee has come back. Even there was a white paper published by the government, which had absolutely, it was rather a black paper by the government. And today again, when the charges against HSBC of doing money laundering, and he has mentioned the names of several individuals and including Congress politicians. One doesn't know actually whose names are there and whose names are not. We are not the right people to make comments on it. But all these charges deserves investigation. The government must come forth, and the Prime Minister must personally answer who is responsible. What Mr. Kejriwal is saying, is it a truth? If it's a truth, has there been a failure on the part of the government? Or is a government a part of the whole system in saying that such institutions which are playing fraud with the country, they survive in this country?
More national news will follow on the other side of a short break. Stay with us.